We want to solve the system of linear equations using the elimination method or the addition method. A solution to a system of equations is an ordered pair or an x and y value that would satisfy both of the given equations. And the idea behind the elimination method is we want to add these two equations together and when doing so eliminate one of the variables. The only way we can eliminate a variable when we add these equations together is if the x terms or y terms are opposites. So once the equations are in standard form, as we see here, with the x and y terms on the left and the constants on the right, by the way, we should recognize that the x terms and y terms are not opposites. Either one or both equations by a constant so that they are. If we look at the x terms, if we want the x terms to be opposites, since we have 3x and 7x, we'd have to have a negative 21x and a positive 21x. So we'd have to multiply this first equation by either 7 or negative 7, and the second equation by positive 3 or negative 3. So we'd have to multiply both equations by a constant. But if we look at the y terms, here we have plus 1y and here we have plus 5y. If this was minus 5y, the y terms would be opposites. So we can make the y terms opposites if we multiply the first equation by negative 5. Let's go ahead and do that. We're going to multiply both sides of the equation by negative 5, which would give us negative 15x minus 5y equals positive 50. Because the y term is already plus 5y, we're going to leave the second equation the same. So we'll have 7x plus 5y equals negative 18. And now when we add these two equations together, notice how we have minus 5y plus 5y. The y terms would have a sum of 0. The sum of the x terms would be negative 8x. And over here we have positive 32. So now we can divide both sides by negative 8. And now we know x must equal negative 4. We're not done though, because remember the solution is an ordered pair. We know x equals negative 4. Now we have to perform substitution into equation 1 or equation 2 and then solve for y. Let's go ahead and use equation 1 and substitute negative 4 for x. We would have 3 times negative 4 plus y equals negative 10. Well, this would be negative 12 plus y equals negative 10. So we'd add 12 to both sides. And here we have y equals positive 2. So our solution is x equals negative 4 and y equals 2. And since we have one unique solution, we can say the system is consistent because it has at least one solution and the equations are independent because they are different. Now let's go ahead and verify our solution. We'll substitute x equals negative 4 and y equals 2 into both equation 1 and equation 2. So for equation 1, we'd have 3 times negative 4 plus 2 equals negative 10. This would be negative 12 plus 2, which is negative 10. So this satisfies equation 1, and now let's check equation 2. We would have 7 times negative 4 plus 5 times 2 equals negative 18. So we have negative 28 plus 10 equals negative 18, which is also true. And we'll go ahead and stop here for this example. I hope you found it helpful.